In this video, we're talking about the chemical equation. So when a chemical reaction happens, we can describe that reaction by writing down a chemical equation. And there's always, in a chemical equation, it looks something like this down here, and there's always an arrow, and everything that's written to the left of that arrow is what we call a reactant. Reactants are the species that are there before the reaction happens. They're what's coming together to make the reaction happen. Everything that's on the right-hand side of the arrow, well, that's what's there after the reaction happens. Those are called products. So reactants on the left, products on the right. There's some things in here we should notice. First of all, the numbers that I've written in front of the formulas, these are called coefficients, and we'll see what those are for in just a moment. And we also have these symbols in parentheses after the formula. And they tell you what phase that substance is in. AQ, this is supposed to be an AQ, and that stands for aqueous, which means it's dissolved in water. That's an S, means it's a solid, and there's several. Notice that the plus sign here separates different things. So the plus means that they're separate. That's going to be important, because later on we're going to see in some of the reactions that it looks, the only difference is going to be there's like a bullet on the left-hand side and a plus on the right, but that means something. So keep that in mind for later. So these are the symbols that you're going to see most commonly used in chemical equations. You should memorize them, what they mean, what they are. AQ stands for aqueous, and it means it's dissolved in water. S stands for a solid. G for a gas. L for a liquid. And if you see a triangle, usually it's above the arrow. That means that heat is being added to make the chemical reaction happen. So memorize these symbols. The law of conservation of mass, well, it says that matter can be neither created nor destroyed. And the way we apply that in chemistry is in a chemical equation that describes a chemical reaction. If matter can neither be created nor destroyed, then that means that however many atoms of a given element we have on the left-hand side of the arrow, we must have that same number of atoms on the right-hand side of the arrow. Now, on the left-hand side of the arrow, let's look at how many of each element, atoms of each element. So this subscript 2 means that it applies to everything to the left. So there's 2 atoms of iron here over on the right. Now these coefficients that I mentioned earlier, they apply to what's to the right, to the compound that they're in front of. And so this 2 means that there are 2 units of this iron 3 phosphate. And because in each unit there is 1 iron atom, we have 2 atoms of iron. So 2. So you can think about it like this. There's a 1 in front here. If there's no coefficient written, that means it's a 1. So 1 up here times a 2 is 2 atoms of iron. 2 here, and if there's no subscript, that means it's a 1. So 2 times 1 is 2. So we have 2 atoms of iron on each side. Let's look at, let's do sulfur. And I'll tell you something about that in a minute. So this, if there's a parenthesis and a subscript after that, that subscript outside of the parentheses, well, it applies to everything inside the parentheses. So there's 1 out here that applies to this, to everything in here. So the 1 sulfur times 3 is there's 3 sulfurs to the left. On the right, there's 3 in front times 1 here is 3 sulfurs on the right. So sulfur's balance, we say. Now oxygen, okay, there's 1 in front here times 1 here times 4 times 3. So it's 4 times 3 is 12 oxygens here, and 2 times 4 is 8 here. So we have a total of 20 oxygens on the left. On the right, we have 2 times 4 is 8, plus 3 times 4 is 12, 8 and 12 is 20. We have 20 oxygens. Potassiums, 2 times 3 is 6 on the left, 3 times 2 is 6 on the right. Phosphorus, 2 times 1 is 2, 2 times 1 is 2. So everything's balanced. Now, there's a shortcut, and I use it all the time, and I really recommend it to you. That is, if you have a polyatomic ion that appears on both sides of the arrow, then you can treat it as just one thing. So when I'm looking at this to see if it's balanced, I say, okay, 2 irons, fine. Now I say, okay, there's 3 sulfates. SO4, 2 minus is sulfate. So there are 3 sulfates on the left. On the right, there's 3 times 1. You know, there's 1 sulfate in each of these, and there's 3 potassium sulfates, so there's 3 sulfates here. So we have 3 sulfates on both sides. That's balanced. Same thing for phosphate. There's 1 phosphate in each potassium phosphate, and there are 2 potassium phosphates, So that means there's two phosphates on the left. And two iron, three phosphates on the right. So there's two phosphates, two phosphate polyatomic ions on the right. Phosphates are balanced. And then we just have potassium, 2 times 3 is 6, 3 times 2 is 6. When you get a chemical equation, you should never assume that it's balanced. We have to balance it. It has to be balanced for it to make any sense to us most of the time. So what you do is you go through and you do pretty much what we just did. You check and see if we have the same number of each atom, of the atoms of each element, rather, on both sides of the arrow. If you don't, then you're probably going to have to balance it. You're just going to have to balance it. And the way you do that, there's only one way to balance it, and that is by adjusting the coefficients. Something that people try to do at first is adjust the subscripts. Don't do that, because if you change the subscripts, you change the compound, and it's not the same reaction anymore, something totally different. Probably doesn't even make sense. So just adjust the coefficients. Now, this one's already balanced, but let's try this. So we have this chemical equation, and this question right here is one of the ways I will ask you questions on a multiple choice test about balancing chemical equations, and that is, what is the sum of the coefficients when this equation is balanced? And the answer is 19, but let's see how we get there. So we want to balance this. Now, there's a few tricks that will help make it easier for you. First of all, and remember this, okay? Listen. If you're balancing a chemical equation and you start going in circles, you change something, which changes something, which makes you have to change the first thing again, like that. And don't like, you know, get like stubborn and try to keep doing it. Just stop and start fresh. And most of the time you want to start with a different element to balance. Another thing, another trick that's really useful is if you have an element that's by itself, like here we have oxygen by itself, always leave that until last. The reason is that you can put, once you get everything else balanced, then you except for the element, in this case the oxygen, then you know you're going to finish, because you can put any number you want to in front of here. Now, when we first balance an equation, it doesn't have to be whole number coefficients. But for our final answer, now this is important, we want the smallest set of whole number coefficients possible to balance that equation. Remember that, write that down. Smallest set of whole number coefficients. So let's do this, right? So we're going to balance this. And I'm going to leave the oxygen for last. So let's look at the carbons. We have two here, one here. So the only two we have are coefficients. So I'm going to put a two there, okay? Now we have two carbons on each side. Notice they changed the number of oxygens, but that's okay. And so I'm going to leave oxygen for last. So next I'm going to do hydrogen. Well, there's six here, two here. So that means I put a three in front, right? Because three times two is six. All right, so now I've got carbon and hydrogen balanced. Now I'm going to look at oxygen. So on the right-hand side here, I have two times two is four. And 3 times 1 is 3. And that's not 40 and 30, that's 3 oxygens and 4 oxygens. So we have 7 oxygens on the right. We have 2 on the left. So here's what you do. You ask yourself, what coefficient goes here? In other words, 2 times what is equal to 7? Or you could write down a little equation. 2 times x is equal to 7. And I know you can all solve that, right? Just divide by 2. X is equal to 7 halves. That means if we put a 7 halves in front of here, we'll have a balanced equation, because 7 halves times 2 is 7. Now we have 7 oxygens on the left and 7 on the right. But here's the thing. For your final answer, you want whole number coefficients and the smallest set. So let's get the whole number, okay? So the way you do that is if you had to put a fraction, no big deal, just whatever the denominator is, multiply every coefficient on the left and the right by that what the denominator is, in this case by 2. So that means we're going to multiply everything by 2, which makes this a 7. It gives us a 2 here, of course, right? And puts a 7 here, and we're going to have a 4 and a 6 on the right. So now this, let's check, make sure this is a balanced equation. Well, we have 2 times 2 is 4 carbons on the left, 4 times 1 is 4 carbons on the right. That's good. 2 times 6 is 12 hydrogens on the left. 6 times 2 is 12 hydrogens on the right. Hydrogens are good. 7 times 2 is 14 oxygens on the left. 4 times 2 is 14, I said, right? 7 times 2 is 14. 4 times 2 is 8, plus 6 times 1 is 6. 8 and 6 is 14, so we have 14 oxygens on both sides. Everything's balanced. Now, smallest set. This is the smallest set of whole numbers. Now, this would look like it's balanced if we had like a 4, a 14, an 8, and a 12. But those would not be the smallest set. We could divide all those by 2. If there's a common denominator, common divisor, greater than 1, you have to reduce the coefficient so that you have the smallest set of whole numbers. And so the answer to our question, which is what is the sum of the coefficients, would be 7 plus 2 is 9, plus 4 is 13, plus 6 is 19. The answer is 19. Now, just another word of warning, I guess, is when you're answering a question that's phrased like this, the sum of the coefficients, one of the most common mistakes for people to do is to balance it correctly, but forget about the ones. If there's no coefficient, that still counts as 1. Don't skip the ones.